Good morning, everyone. So I'd like to advise you first about who's gonna be my audience and what my topic is for. So my audience will be our Richmond leadership in IMC.
Richmond.
Yes, you are executives, you are directors, and you are senior unit managers right now. And with Gornick there. And I'm here to persuade and also to give an info about the video handoff process. So that's what I'm here to persuade.
Good evening.
Hi. So my name is Carla, and I'm from Alabang Mission Control, and I am here to discuss about the video handoff process. So who has incurred before being in a video handoff with a blurry, can't understand people? Who's experienced that?
Me.
You?
Okay.
How do you feel about that?
Irritated.
Why? Because you can't hear?
Because the communication is not clear.
That's right. And it's kind of frustrating, correct?
Yes.
Okay. That's right. So I'm here today is mainly to discuss why there is a need to have a video handoff process between Alabang and Richmond, and of course to give a run through of a step-by-step guide on how we can get there. Okay, so there are actually three main reasons why we should have a video handoff process in place. First off, it promotes engagement. You would like to see people, right?
Yes.
See your face. And second, we want to go ahead and have an efficiency transition. So we have our folks in Richmond, we also have folks in Alabang. So these are worlds apart, so we have to be efficient. And third, is going to be a one-stop shop of information. So to start off, I'll go through a step-by-step guide for the video handoff process. So first is you have